pregnancy test is the it's the main D-day for the patient. So like the result is going to come out. It's for the doctor as well as the patient. But you need not worry about it. So on Google, you need to have, you see lot of reviews, like you should do a pregnancy test on day 12, day 10, day 15. So now let us enumerate that, what does that specifically mean? So if you have got a blastocyst transferred in your womb, somewhere around day 10, you can do a pregnancy test. That is done by blood. So you can do a serum beta HCG test, or you can go for a urine pregnancy test also. But if it is a day 2 or a day 3 transfer, the recommended day for serum beta HCG or the pregnancy test is usually day 15 of the cycle. Now coming to the results of the pregnancy test, that how to decipher it. Like patients say, okay, now when am I pregnant? So basically every patient who gets a pregnancy test done, unless and until the values are very high or still they are high also, we repeat the test every 72 hours. Because now you are pregnant, you are in that zone that it has implanted. But where it has implanted, that is a big question. It is not necessary that it has gone into your womb only in the place where it should go. It can go into your tubes also. You can have a ectopic pregnancy, you can land into a heterotopic pregnancy. So what is a ectopic pregnancy? Ectopic pregnancy means the embryos have implanted, but they have implanted in the tubes or somewhere else, not in the endometrial lining where it should have. So if every, like if the beta HCG should rise 2.5 times every 72 hours, if it is rising more than that, then you are in deep trouble. Or a third scenario is there when you have a heterotopic pregnancy, means one embryo is in this, like the uterine cavity in the endometrial lining where it should be, and the other is somewhere else. Somewhere else can be anywhere. It might be in the tubes, it might be in the ovaries, it might be in the cervical region, anywhere. So we need to reduce that pregnancy. It is also a race against time. So it is very essential that after doing your blood pregnancy test, you should see your infertility specialist. Now if everything is fine, like if I presume that it is increasing at a normal pace as it is, it should. Then we get a ultrasound done after 1 week just to see whether the gestational sac has formed or not. Then again another scan is done after 7 to 10 days to see for the cardiac activity. So now the question comes whether you get a cardiac activity or not. If you have not got a cardiac activity, then it is just a biochemical pregnancy. Like your beta HCG was positive, but ultimately it is a failed IVF cycle. For us, or for every good infertility centers, we usually say that a pregnancy test is positive when you get a cardiac activity in the baby. So all patients who come to us and who are coming from outskirts as well as abroad, for all these patients, we recommend them to fly back after the cardiac activity is through. So for our case, the pregnancy test is negative if it's only a blood pregnancy test. It's positive only when we have a cardiac activity, and more so when you take baby home. So the take home baby rate should be good.